Thirst is the worst.
Thirst the worst, bitch.
Just losing their job or their home just to be open about being gay, lesbian, bisexual, or trans.
Has that, like, how many times do you think that's happened?
It actually does happen frequently. It was actually on the front page news of CNN on their website 2 days ago.
Wow.
About how people are afraid to come out to work because they'll be persecuted.
Like, how many, like, how many instances would you say of people being fired just simply for being LGBTQ there are? Like,
the exact
is there a stat on that?
But I know right now we are taking two specific instances to court.
Right.
So there is more. You can find out the exact stat at hrc.org. They have information about it. One of those instances is here in Wisconsin about teachers that have come out about having female partners, female teachers, and parents calling and complaining until the teacher got fired.
Like a public school? Or?
Yep.
Yeah.
Was it a private school or
public school?
Pretty sure?
I'm pretty sure. I don't know, you have to look at
I remember growing up when I was going to Catholic school, somebody had been like exposed as being, like having a kid out of wedlock, and then they fired her for teaching Spanish at the Catholic school, private parochial school, which like a private institution would have like, you know, the carte blanche to do that.
But do they have the carte blanche to fire an employee that's been good for 20 years because they find out that they're gay?
Exactly.
I would say yes, though, because they're a private institution. They probably have
but it happens in public schools.
And also, just you don't have the right to fire somebody because of their color of their skin, their orientation.
Do you think they should?
No, you should be allowed to have racism in the system.
So racism should be illegal. Like thought crime should be like a crime.
Firing somebody because of their race, I think. Or not hiring somebody because of their race.
How do you prove that that's the bias at play? You know what I mean?
That is a hard problem, but there are instances where they're very open about it.
That's my main gripe with that, is how do you like prove like...
And that is the problem. You can't prove it, but you can discourage it. And so that's where laws like the Civil Rights Act come into play. And this would actually be, we're trying to pass the Equality Act through Congress, which would essentially be adding sexual orientation and non-binary sexual identification into the Civil Rights Act.
Non-binary, what is, so that's like anybody can just be whatever.
Transgender, or they, people that don't identify with a specific gender.
Which is not
so
biological.
Something outside of male and female.
Right, so that's not
so
biologically.
That's what we're trying to actually like, pass through sound. Congress. But unfortunately, we are facing more anti-discrimination across the country. In Kansas and Oklahoma last month, we had state-funded adoption agencies that legally discriminate against LGBTQ couples for adoption services. So things like that are going on in both.
I love Harley. So glad I'm here.
By giving you donations and help us get
I don't have a job.
That's on the Harley too, bro. There's
a whole lot I can do on my end, but I mean, I've definitely, you know, I've participated in, you know, in being at least being aware of it, you know, in school.
And like, you can definitely learn more information at hrc.org as well. And please get out there and support LGBTQ positive candidates, because here in Wisconsin, actually, three pieces of anti-LGBTQ legislation coming up for both in the fall legislative session. And we're also trying to
What are those
I don't have the details. If I tell you the details, you're going to rip me apart already. So I'm going to tell you to go to hrc.org to get the exact details on those bills.
I just want to know to what degree or how ubiquitous this is of people being fired simply for being gay.
And you can find that information
At public institutions.
But it shouldn't be public. Private institutions should also not be allowed to discriminate on sexual orientation for who they hire.
So, like, don't you, I mean, wouldn't you agree with freedom of association as just a principle?
No, not for an employee. Like, if you're like, hiring, you can't not hire somebody at McDonald's because they're gay. Like, that's not right.
I would agree that that would be a bizarre value to hold. You know what I mean?
It
I would,
shouldn't be appropriate.
If I owned a business, I would be like, oh, yeah, hire whoever the fuck. I don't care. But, like, I also can't.
Candidate should not be discriminated.
I can't see, like, how you could tell, have the government compel them to do that.
People are being denied housing because they're transgender, because they're seen as risky people that will cause problems. And that's the exact same thing of renting a house. They're being denied rentals because they're considered risky. And that's the same exact thing that happened to black people. Do you understand that? Like, it's a new bridge that we need to cross where you can't make that assumption because of their gender.
I think it's kind of based on like crime stats though, isn't it?
No, but it's not, because actually LGBTQ are most likely to be victimized.
Right.
So it's reverse. Right. It's based on an assumption and a moral value standard that they're holding people to.
I mean,
it's based on religion that they're interfering with their daily lives.
Right. I mean, I would say that, you know,
you have your freedom to religion, but not to interrupt other people's lives.
Right, and the you would have the freedom to not have to, like, you know, cater a Scott Walker event. I would hope. I would hope you'd have that freedom of association,
yeah,
right?
You don't have the freedom I would to hope deny somebody housing because they're Jewish, right?
I would say that you should be able to deny services for just about any reason because you can't prove that that's what's in their head. That goes to my original point of, like, how do you...
Right, I got to keep working, so I'll let you continue on your way. So.
Okay, I mean...
We're trying to raise funds, so...
Right, I mean, I'm just not sure to what degree, like, public institutions are doing that. Like, if
they
that was,
are. Like,
if that was a
you,
huge thing...
I don't want to give you the exact stats, but you can go to hrc.org and they will have that information. Have instances.
HRC.org.
HRC.org.
Give them money. All right. Thank you.
Vincent?
Yep.
Have a good one.
Are you canvassing or something?
I am.
Yeah. What's happening? What's cracking?
Well, I'm out here for Quality? Human rights campaign. I saw you talking to Tiffany earlier.
Yeah. Quality?
Yep.
So why is equality inherently good? I guess I'll ask.
Well, I think it's fair to give everybody an equal chance across the board.
So, yeah, right, so quality of opportunity.
Yep.
Right. A lot of times people are fighting for a quality of outcome. Like, they look at disparate results across groups, and they sort of infer that it's due to some sort of systemic barrier. And then they fail to present any, like, empirical evidence that it was due to a barrier. That's what I've noticed a lot, so...
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, what kind of systemic barriers do you think are to be removed in your estimation? Just Trumpism?
Trump, Pence. I think there's a lot of religious barriers.
Right. I am no fan of the extreme religious right, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah.
But I think I was talking with your friend over there. I think that they also deserve, like, freedom of association.
Yeah.
Like, it's difficult to prove who's discriminating in their head. And if they fire somebody or won't hire somebody, like, how do we prove that it was due to some sort of bias? Like, implicit bias, you know, like...
I think at that point, you have to take a sample of the people that are being denied and see what
right.
the common characteristic is.
So if they just...
And if somebody's completely qualified
right.
and they would otherwise have gotten a position, then it's, you know, that's where you kind of start to question, well... Why did I not get the job?
That goes back to the original point. So if there's a disparate outcome among groups, it's automatically due to discrimination.
I wouldn't say that.
So, like, I mean, I don't know. Like, there's so many variables,
like,
right?
The biggest problem that I see in Milwaukee is that there are people being denied housing
right.
just for using the term partner on applications.
Like private housing or public housing?
Private
housing markets are explicitly saying that we will not, like, I'm sorry, what was the thing?
So I actually interviewed a couple that they're not heteronormative, however, it's still a man and a woman that prefer to each other as partners.
Right.
And because they use that terminology in applications, they were getting denied left and right.
Partners, so they was the
partner. Yeah, like they weren't even allowed showings.
Partner, so that was.
Yeah.
How did they know that?
They just.
You know what I mean?
Because partner is, for a lot of people, it's assumed that it's a gay partner.
Partner.
That it's a gay relationship.
I have heard that used by people in the LGBT community. I personally, I don't think I've immediately associated with being gay or anything.
A lot of people do, though. I think.
Right.
And
like
so they weren't even allowed showings.
Just for saying partner on the application?
Or cops have to change how they refer to the person they work with. Like, this is my friend. my co-worker.
Right, right. Yeah, I don't know.
We're just co-workers.
I would say if there's widespread systemic bias in public housing, I would say that that's a huge problem. But, like, I don't know, if the private...
I see it more often in private because people claim that they have the choice of who rent to.
I would totally agree with that.
Because of that, a lot of homophobia can be disguised in, like, well, it's my choice.
Right.
Who I'm renting to.
Like, this might sound extreme. Do you think maybe it is their choice to be homophobic? Like, if their brain, you can't, like, again.
Well, legally, they're allowed to be now, because Trump actually signed a bill into law 2 weeks ago granting religious freedom to individuals discriminating against LGBTQ members in just about any capacity.
Right, right.
So, that's really scary.
He campaigned on being an ally to that community, though, like...
He did. He had the LGBT flag.
Yeah. Which, by the way, looked like he scribbled it, like, found a Sharpie backstage and, like, scribbled LGBT.
Like a male on one day, and
how does that work?
Can you be like a man on one day and like female on another day?
There are days where I feel more masculine than feminine.
Right. And I mean, I do too, but I'm still a male. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Like I would feel more. I guess whatever that would mean to me, I would feel more feminine on one day than another.
I guess that would be gender fluidity or gender queer.
So technically that would make me gender queer kind of thing?
If that's how you identify yourself as.
Oh,
so
okay.
You don't have to though.
Yeah, it's all very like new. Like I started noticing this stuff crop up around like 2011. So I think there is like a real, I guess you could say pushback or backlash. Like people are not really ready for it.
It's because it's different from the norm.
They're not really ready for it. It was like all really fast and really recent.
Native American cultures are recognized like 13 genders.
Right.
Yeah, I believe so.
Interesting.
I think it's like in India, don't quote me on that, but yes, it does exist in other cultures, you know.
India, it's actually not that accepted.
Okay, I could be wrong on that. That's why I said
don't quote
me on that, but yeah.
Definitely.
Okay, well, yeah, thanks for talking to me.
Yeah, thank you.
Versus the wife.
Subscribe, bitch!